Yo guys, what's going on? Zace is here today with another video. In today's video, we are going to be talking about the Call of Duty Modern Warfare 2 benchmark, and if you are getting a bottleneck on your GPU, hopefully I can alleviate some of your worries. Guys, do me a favor, make sure you're dropping a like, and of course, make sure you're subscribing to the channel. So, on the right is my system information. Not sure if it's going to be blurred or not, but if it is, I'm running a 3070 Ti GPU, just for reference, because we are primarily talking about the GPU bottleneck here in Call of Duty Modern Warfare 2. But, you know, if it's not, you can see all my info there. But like I said, I don't know if it's going to be blurred or not. So, guys, if you are experiencing a 99% bottleneck, like right here, you see how mine's at 99%. I want you to understand, if you are shooting for graphics quality, so if your settings are all set to high or ultra or very high, whatever the highest setting is, then this is fine. Having a 99% bottleneck on your GPU means that your GPU is using its full performance. It's using its full power towards Modern Warfare 2. So if you have a 99% bottleneck and you want high quality graphics, then you are okay. You don't have anything to worry about. But if you are not shooting for super high quality, high res graphics, then there might be a problem. And I'm going to give you a couple of examples of what could be wrong. Number one, make sure you check your render resolution and compare that to your display resolution. It'll be on the right under system information. Make sure they match up. If you're on 100 render resolution, you might see that it's 920 by 1088. That's still okay. You're not really going to run into any issues with that being 8 off. You'll be okay. So make sure those are matching relatively. That's number one. So if you're running your game on like 144% on the render res, yeah, you're probably going to have some issues with your GPU. It's probably not going to be giving you the best performance because you're on wrong settings. Number two, make sure your GPU driver is up to date. If you're on NVIDIA, you know, you have a GeForce Experience app and all that, make sure you're on the 52661 driver. It's the hotfix driver. I think they are working on the next patch and the next driver for NVIDIA cards. So make sure you're looking out for that in the future from this video. But at the time of recording on November 12th, 2022, make sure you're on 52661. And that can also be found on like the help page of NVIDIA, because I don't think it's on the official driver page. Another thing that you guys might run into, you might stumble upon this video and you're like, well, I don't have a GPU bottleneck, I have a CPU bottleneck. That's something completely different and you need to look into that. Look into everything pretty much regarding your PC and figure out what's wrong. You might have to do some pretty major troubleshooting for that one. Another thing though, if you guys are shooting for the really high performance graphics, you can still get more performance and still use all of your GPU. So if I wanted to go in and maybe lower particle lighting and stuff like that, so when those streaks come in, I could probably get some more FPS, because you see my low first is 99 FPS. Well, that was when a streak came in and it was a bunch of explosions. So if I wanted to turn some of that quality down, I could get a little more performance in that department, but it's a very, very small variable and something that doesn't happen too often. So it's one of those settings that I leave on the highest setting, because personally, when it does come in, all of my videos for my YouTube channel are still coming in at 60 FPS for the viewer. So for me, I would rather have the higher quality shown on the recording, and then I personally will take the FPS performance hit when it comes to my personal experience. You know, some people are different. Some people want the max FPS, but after multiple years of testing of Modern Warfare 2019, Warzone, and the past two Call of Duties, I found that the game just looks way better in recordings when you're not maxing out your FPS. So for me, I could easily get probably 240 FPS by knocking my settings the entire way down, put everything on low, and then maybe bump up a couple things. And then I would probably be just frying, but at the same time, I just rather have an enjoyable experience when it comes to graphics, and at the same time, have my viewers of the channel really, really enjoy what they're watching when it comes to gameplay. So, you know, in the future, if we ever do hit our big milestones of 100,000, 500,000, a million subscribers in the far future, then obviously we'll have dual streaming PCs and all that stuff where it won't even be an issue. We could be maxing out our FPS and recording everything in 4K. But right now, we're still in the startup stage, it seems like, when it comes to almost hitting 20,000 subs. So I highly encourage you to subscribe to the channel if you're into a bunch of Call of Duty Modern Warfare 2 content. Hopefully, I helped you out a little bit here today. Anybody that wants to roast me for my average FPS, that's fine. I'm sure you just don't understand. But we're going to be making another video here soon about how the benchmark works. So make sure you're looking out for that. But hopefully I helped some of you guys out, man. If I did, like I said, the likes really appreciate it. It's going to be it for me. Thank you so much for stopping by. I'm out.